Hello everyone, I am Professor Shaista Khanum from Vidyavardhini's College of Engineering. We'll brief you about arm exceptions, interrupts and the vector table. So interrupt and exceptions are the very important points for any microcontroller or processor. So in arm we have two interrupts, that is nothing but IRQ and FIQ. So what is interrupt? Interrupt is nothing but the processor or a controller is doing something and we want that the processor or microcontroller should stop what they are doing, and we want something, another operation that can be, that we want that the controller should do. So that operation we can make the processor or controller to do with the help of interrupt. So in ARM, we have two interrupt, IRQ and FIQ. This is interrupt request and this is fast interrupt request. Now, what is fast interrupt request? This interrupt is will be used when the application needs a very fast operation. At that time, FIQ will be used. So, FIQ is again a high priority interrupt and interrupt IRQ is a low priority interrupt. What is the meaning of priority? That means if both interrupts are coming at the same time, then the FIQ will be executed first and then the IRQ. Now, why it is called as fast interrupt? Because some banked registers are there which are used in when the processor is switching from one mode to another mode. So, if you see for FIQ, in FIQ, the bank registers are available from R18 to R14, whereas in IRQ, we have only two bank registers, which are R13 and R14. That means, when you are switching from any mode to the fast interrupt mode, then less number of registers are there, which has to be stored by, we need that those registers when we'll come back to the main program again. But in IRQ, we don't have this many registers where you can what you can use in the interrupt request mode. So we have only R13 and R14. That means R13 and R14 of the previous mode will be kept as it is, and the R13 and R14 of the IRQ will come in picture. So that is a very brief introduction. You can just go through the textbook also. Then exceptions. Exceptions are nothing but an error which can occur in a processor or controller. So here in ARM, there are different exceptions are occurring through the exceptions can occur during the execution of the instruction. It can be a software interrupt, any undefined instructions, or some memory abort, or during nothing but what a fetching of the instructions also, then due to the reset or FIQ, due to the interrupt execution also may be possible. While executing the interrupt, some exceptions can occur, some error can occur. So what has to be done? If anything wrong is happening, we are getting some problem, then how to tackle that? That is nothing but what a exception execution. Now, whenever interrupt or exception comes, see, if interrupt is coming, we have some dedicated thing to be done by that interrupt. So that is nothing but a sort of program that is called as interrupt service routine. That interrupt service routine will be executed whenever the interrupt is executed. In the same thing, when the exception will occur, in a particular exceptions, we can tell the controller to do the particular thing, to display some message, to do something. But that can be done by writing some program, and that program is written in an interrupt service routine. And interrupt service routine, where that interrupt service routine is in a memory, the first address of that interrupt service routine is written into some register, into some memory, sorry, not register, memory, and that memory area is called as interrupt vector table. So, interrupt vector table is nothing but what a dedicated area, which is where the address of the sub ISR routines are stored. So, these are some of the exceptions: reset, undefined instructions, software interrupt, prefetch abort, data abort, IRQ and FIQ. So, these are some exception types. And when, suppose, something IRQ is occurring, then what will happen? The processor will take the address 00001B from this interrupt vector table, and on this address there will be some branch instruction. You can see on for reset it is 000, for undefined instruction it is 004. So only four bytes are allocated for one interrupt. In four bytes we cannot write the big ISR. So what will happen with the help of this four bytes? Only here the branch instructions are written on this address, and this branch instruction will take you to the ISR. So whenever interrupt, so I hope this interrupt vector table is clear. Now what is address? What is in normally in any processor, the interrupt vector table is placed at the starting address 0000, or it can be placed at higher address also 0xfff000. So these are nothing but what about interrupt vector table. So interrupt vector table is containing the address where the program whenever the interrupt will or the exception will occur, the controller will go to that address, and on that address some branch instruction will be written, and that will take you to the interrupt service routine. Now, before going to what will happen when the interrupt will come, first of all we should understand what are the different types of exceptions. First is reset. Reset is nothing but a condition whenever the power is on. What will happen? The processor, after whenever the power is on, it will enter, it will go to this instruction, and in this instruction it will go to the ISR, and in that ISR some initialization code must be there, which is going to initialize the ARM processor, and it is going to initialize the processor, or it is going to run some monitor program. Then undefined instruction. In reset also it will initialize all the registers to 000, program counter, link register, or CPSR. So it will make all these registers, reset all these registers. So that reset, that operation will be done by executing the ISR. So that is nothing but what a ISR written for reset. Then we have undefined instruction. What is undefined instruction? When the processor is unable to decode the instruction, that means the processor is not able to identify which instruction. That means this instruction is undefined for ARM. So that is undefined instruction. Whenever this exception will occur, the processor will go to the address 000004. Then we have software interrupt. Software interrupt will occur when the SWI instruction will be executed. And mainly this instruction is frequently used as a mechanism to invoke an operating system routine. So that is nothing but what? Software interrupt vector. Another is prefetch abort. Prefetch abort is nothing but whenever this processor is attempting to fetch an instruction from an address without a correct access to the memory. That means processor is trying to access some memory which the processor is not allowed to access. That means suppose in this mode, that is nothing but what a coming the point is coming in picture is privileged mode and non-privileged. Suppose the processor is in a user mode. So in a user mode, it is a non-privileged mode where all the access is not given to the user. So that means at that time processor is trying to access a memory which user mode is not having the access. Suppose which the system mode is having, that is a privileged mode. So this error, this exception can occur. Another is data abort. Data abort is nothing but very similar to prefetch. The only difference is nothing but instruction of attempt to access the data from the unauthorized memory access, from the memory which is not authorized by that mode. So prefetch and data, first is nothing but where you are fetching the instruction, and second you are fetching the data. Then next is interrupt request. So whenever a normal execution, so this is nothing but what a hardware interrupt. But this interrupt and FIQ is nothing but what, again a hardware interrupt, but it is high priority and low priority, and FIQ is faster. So for fast applications, we need FIQ, but FIQ and RIQ, IRQ will be identified if it is not masked in CPSR. What is CPSR? It is current program status register. So that register is going to store the condition of all the flags, which mode, and whether the interrupt is masked or not masked. Masked means interrupt is disabled. So if it is disabled in CPSR, then the interrupt will not be recognized. So the last point is, when the interrupt or exception is occurring, what will happen first? First of all, processor is here. I forgot to write. First is processor will complete what he is doing. So first of all, it will complete what it is doing. Then next, processor switches to the privilege mode, where everyone is not having the access. Then it is nothing but normally in a system mode. And then current value of PC plus 4 is saved in a link register, because you are doing something. So you are currently finishing, but the next instructions are remaining. So after executing the instruction, interrupt, you want to come back to where you were before the execution of the interrupt. So in order to come back, you have to save the program counter register plus 4 into the link register, so you will come back to the next instruction. Then after that, the CPSR content will be copied into the SPSR of the privileged mode, so that whatever is the currently in CPSR will be saved in SPSR. Now, if exception has been caused by FIQ and IRQ, then it will also be disabled. Then program counter loaded with PC will be loaded with the exception vector address from the interrupt vector table. So those address I was talking about, so this address will be loaded in a program counter. So the program flow will go to this those address, and then the interrupt execution or exception execution will start. So I hope these steps are, this is similar like what we have done in 8051 or any processor controller, how the interrupts are executed. More or less the procedure is same, except something privilege mode, or that is the only difference. The rest, always we are storing a program counter, always we are storing the flag register content. So that we are doing it here also. And the ISR address is taken from the interrupt vector table. So I hope it is clear. Even though if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you so much.